Charles in charge. No one likes my new courses.
Oh, hello there. Didn't see you come in, Nestarinos. You come down the right warp pipe, because you're back in the red zone, where I'm playing the best Mario Maker levels every day. Yours. We may not be popular, we may not be hot, but we're here and we're getting featured. The best puzzle level, the best platformer, the best theme level, the best throwback, and the wild card. That's five every weekday. I want to take a minute to thank all of my friends on Reddit and Facebook for their great support for this channel so far. Without your kind words and your levels, I wouldn't even be here. So thank you so much, and if you want to be featured right here in the red zone, stick through until the end of the video, and I will tell you how you can get your level played right here by me, some idiot on the internet. And also, I will tell you the Nintendo joke of the day. What are we waiting for? Game on! Alright, Nestheads, we are starting off today with our wild card, the Skeleton Tree by Nightjar. This is an underground Super Mario World based puzzle platform level where you are underground in the skeleton's graveyard and you must find three giant 50 gold pieces before you are allowed to make your way to the goal. Each of these gold pieces is hidden in a room that presents a unique puzzle in each one. Here is a course clear KidNES pro tip. If you want to grab this coin, just get in the turtle shell, make the jump, hit the right trigger, and you're going to bounce out of that shell and get enough height to collect that coin. I don't want to spoil too much, but I spent quite a bit of time in this level. It's not overly difficult, but it is a lot of fun. The aesthetics are pretty cool. I had fun with every one of the rooms and every one of the puzzles. It took me a couple of tries to get through everything. And after I beat it all, I came back. You can see right there, if you don't have enough coins, you are not going to be able to progress the third door. You're going to need to find a secret P-switch. I'm not going to spoil where that is, but if you find the P-switch and you bring it up there, you're going to be able to get in that door. I spent a lot of time in this level. I even came back and set the world record on it. So if you want to come and take the world record away from NES, well, load up the Skeleton Tree and give it a shot. That's our wild card for today. Our themed level of the day is Super Final Fantasy Bros. By the Toadinator. You know that KidNES is a huge Final Fantasy fan. I had Final Fantasy 1 way back in the day, and I played the holy heck out of that game, so I love the Warriors of Light. This level, this is more of an aesthetic and music level. You're not going to find a lot of challenge here, but there are three rooms here where you're going to have to use your fight skill, your magic skill, and your item skill to progress. The challenges are quite easy. This level is more about the experience and the joy of looking at it than getting challenged, so you're going to find a nice relaxing playthrough after you solve the three puzzles and grab the four keys. That's right, three puzzles, four keys, I said it. You are going to come to this room where you are granted with 20 experience points and 50 gil, and then you're going to be able to sail down this boat down the river and listen to some Final Fantasy music as you grab the flag. I had to put this one in here because it looked so good, it made me smile, and at the end of the day, that's what it's all about. Final Fantasy. Snow Job by Meggan is our platforming level of the day. This is a very pleasant and aesthetically pleasing, fun, relaxing romp through a snow world. Once again, we're not going for challenge here. There are and have been a couple of challenging levels in the KidNES Fave 5, but sometimes you just like to play what makes you happy, and Snow Job is a really cool level. There are a couple of nice jumps and some rough bumps. As you can see, KidNES, dumb enough to get in the way of this turtle shell, is about to eat a horrible death. And some other people have as well, so we can't say there's absolutely no challenge, but this level is a lot of fun. It's platforming goodness, and you should be able to easily get in there and get that course clear and try and take the world record away. Guess who has the world record? Well, it's me, KidNES. I liked this level a lot, it looked good, and it made me feel happy, just like a little kid, when I played it. And this is our platforming level of the day. Course clear pro tip, get into this Lakitu's cloud to easily skip through that last part of the level, and make that spin jump to get that course clear. Great Scott! Our theme level of the day is a return to 1985, a Back to the Future themed level. So why don't you make like a tree and get out of here, go download this course and play it right now. It is totally awesome. When you get back to Hill Valley, you are going to find yourself in World 1-1. Yes, a 1-1 and 1-2 remix stage. But somebody has messed with a temporal timeline. The flux capacitor has gone out of control. As you can see, this isn't the 1-1 and 1-2 that you remember. But it is a really cool stage. I had a lot of fun with this one. I love playing through classic Super Mario Brothers levels. And Back to the Future is one of the greatest movies ever made. So, you know, you put one in one hand, one in the other, you put your hands together. When you get down in World 1-2, you're going to find this one is a little different as well. The level is quite fun, quite charming. I really like the way it looks. And, of course, the Back to the Future theme, you can't beat that. I went straight through here to get to the end, but you know, if you know your 1-2, you know where that hidden warp zone is and how to get there, and I have the world record on this level as well, so if you want to come and try and take it away from me, good luck, pal, because you're gonna need it. Nobody calls me chicken. It Takes a Big Man to Be Small by Bearking is our puzzle level of the day. This one is quite neat. You are going to go through this classic Super Mario Brothers 1 level, and you're going to have to grab giant mushrooms to solve portions of these puzzles, but then you're going to have to, as you can see here, you're not going to be able to get through with those giant, you're going to have to shrink yourself back down to size to complete the next portions of the level. So the level is switching back and do not get trapped in there, I'll tell you that. This level is switching back and forth between being giant Toadette and normal sized Toadette. It took me quite a few tries to get through. This one actually does have a little bit of challenge here. This guy says there's a troll at the end. I never experienced that. I got right through to the end eventually and got myself a course clear. The highlight of this level is this platform and piranha plant. Or what are those? Piranha plants? Well, whatever the heck they're called. This part gave me quite a bit of trouble, but once you figure it out, it's quite satisfying to get through. And here is a second course clear pro tip. As you come by this giant bomb contraption, do not let the invincibility star float off the end of the stage, because guess what? If you do, you're dead. But persistence is the key. If you mess up, just come back and do it again. This level is quite fun. It's quite charming, and I really enjoyed it. This is our puzzle level of the day. It Takes a Big Man to Be Small. Congratulations.
Yowie wowie! Today's levels were so totally awesome! There was the one in the snow, and the one where you turn big, and then you shrink down, and all the other ones that I was talking about. Well, that's another day finished in the Rad Zone. I hope you enjoyed watching these levels being played by me. And if you want to put your video, your level, and I make your level into a video right here in the Rad Zone, then you can just leave a comment down in the comment section below. And please subscribe. And I ask that you please play at least one other person's level, because we want these levels to blow up. Getting featured in the Rad Zone is totally awesome. And you can too. Well, that's it. See you again tomorrow, Ness Heads. I totally forgot the joke of the day. So here it is. Why is Petey Piranha the best Mario Kart driver? Because he has the most pedals. Yuck, yuck.